instructions? On my way. All clear.
At the moment, all our settlers are in the Pathfinder, and you can explore the surrounding area with them. But time is tight. When the water in the Pathfinder is used up, everyone inside will die of thirst.
We have found a new zone. Take a look at it when you get a chance. It might be worth it to build a new settlement on it.
All clear. Got it?
This transfer point serves as an access point for vehicles and connects your zone with the surrounding wasteland. Look for an ascent on the perimeter of your new zone where you can place the access point. You have to find a location that is supposed to become the center of the settlement. Once chosen, you won't be able to change. First off, we have to ensure survival. The jetty produces water as long as workers are assigned to it. Always make sure that sufficient water is available. If the supply runs low, assign more settlers to work at the jetty. Water alone is not enough to survive. We need to eat, too. Build a foraging hut near trees. The foraging hut produces food as long as there are sufficient resources in its vicinity. If a region's resources are used up at some point, we need building materials to be able to build new buildings in the future too. The woodcutting lodge cuts down trees, which produces wood. Woodcutting lodge is already producing. By the way, a production site can produce faster when it stands near a depot. Although you don't have any depots, besides wood, the most important building material is scrap. That's what the scrapyard is for. It collects scrap that lies around and takes apart old ruins. Well done. On the other hand, our settlers are still sleeping out in the open. Each building belongs to one of three settlement branches. The more buildings that stand in one settlement branch of the settlement, the more these buildings progress in that branch. This progress enables us to do research on new buildings from that branch. More about research, but that's not all. Production buildings that have a dwelling from the same settlement branch nearby function distinctly more effectively, too. If an ecological tent stands next to a jetty, then the jetty functions more effectively. In contrast, the scrapyard and woodcutting lodge profit from economic tents. As long as they have enough housing, our settlers will reproduce and have children. Our settlement is thriving. Now we want to produce a new resource, plastic. Buildings that process resources work faster when they are located near their source. The recycler, the toolmaker, not only needs scrap, but wood as well. It's best when both resources are produced near him. But don't worry if you're not able to. Very good. Now we have plastic and tools, things which are needed in some buildings for production. The settlement is growing, and soon the supplies won't be sufficient anymore. More settlers consume more food and water, too. Though the fishery is more effective than the foraging hut, it constantly uses up tools for its production. If there are no tools, then the fishery can't function. Conversely, the fishery produces faster when tools are produced near it. Now, we also need cloth to be able to set up more tents. Cloth is produced from fibers, and we have to grow them first. To do this, build a plantation in the vicinity of fertile soil. The only way you can create a field is on fertile soil. Well done. Up till now, we can only grow fibers, but if we find more types of seeds, then we can cultivate them on the plantation too. The fibers are crafted into cloth at a weaving mill. This requires water in addition to fibers, so make sure that Great! Now you can set up more tents for our settlers to create space for new inhabitants. This is necessary too, because we're going to need a lot of hard-working hands. Keep in mind to place the tents near the appropriate production. We'll be right back. Thanks to our joint efforts, our little settlement is soon. If the population increases, then the settlement supply situation has to grow too. Apart from the jetty, the supply situation is stable. Soon our depots will be filled to the brim. When the depots are full, you have to increase their capacity. There is a depot for water. Each depot increases the maximum number of resources that can be stockpiled at a settlement. When your depots are full, buildings cannot produce any further. Besides the short distance to a depot, good availability is important for production buildings. A production site produces more effectively. Super! The more buildings you connect via your road network, the more stable the production at your settlement is going to be able to run. When our economy thrives, it uses up more resources too. Luckily, we're able to have our wood grow back again. We have the tree nursery for that. awesome. The tree nursery will plant trees within its work area that can be used again by the woodcutting lodge. That way, we create a healthy loop.
The needles of the Geiger counters begin to swing hotter. A sharp increase in radiation is going to occur soon.
Oh no! I had hoped we'd have more time. Now we have to act fast. We need is made from wood. When wood gets scarce, assign more settlers to the woodcutting lodge, or build a second one. The tailor shop can make protective masks out of coal and cloth. They ought to be sufficient at first. Our settlement already produces cloth, and you have just taken care of getting protective clothing is truly a blessing. It is issued to the settlers automatically. If a settlement is contaminated and our settlers are unprotected,
our fears have been confirmed.
The higher the radiation level in a zone, the better we have to protect our settlers. If the protective clothing, when the radiation exposure gets too high, our settlers will gradually die of it. Even if the protection is sufficient at first, we should also prepare ourselves soon against potentially stronger radiation. Regardless of whether due to radiation, a poor supply situation, or simply getting too old, sooner or later, we have to say farewell to every settler. We need a place where we can Thanks a lot. Now we have a place to mourn and commemorate those who had to come and go before our time. I think we've put down roots here and can we're not able to extract clay just like that yet. For some advanced to be able to perform research, first you have to track down ancient knowledge in the wasteland. The thing is, you can start an expedition at some of the ruins there.
New instructions? Engine running! On my way! Let's go! New instructions? Engine running! On my way. On my way. Got it? On my way. On my way. Got it? Got it? Got it? All clear. Got it? All clear. Where are we going?
There's a converted buggy standing in this garage. We ought to take a closer look at it. The best would be if we tried to lower the car lift somehow. Let's go! As long as the car lift is raised, we can't examine the vehicle. I'm in. The mattress hasn't been used for a while, but whoever fixed up their cars here lived here for a spell too. Sure is lonesome out here. This control unit needs power in order to work. This generator is still in good shape, but we won't be able to use it without fuel. On the road.
I'm at the wheel. Got it? There's a converted buggy standing in this garage. We ought to take a closer look at it. The best would be if we try to lower the car lift somehow. I'll do it. On the road! This generator is still in good shape, but we won't be able to use it without fuel. Will do. Jerry cans with gasoline in them are lying here. Can we use them? Let's go! The generator's running and supplying electricity. Done! That's a really unusual construction design. The vehicle's not fit to drive anymore, but maybe our experts at home can do something with it.
Our explorers have extensively explored this ruin. And consequently, to be able to research a technology also means that our settlement branches need to be far enough advanced. Build additional buildings which are allocated to the branch in order to make progress at that. Great! We can build clay pits with that. Our settlers will have to visit unfamiliar places in the future as well in order to accumulate sufficient knowledge for more research. It might even be that now is a good time to explore some more ruins. Whatever you say. Clay is mined at a clay pit, which has to be placed at a clay deposit. If there is no clay deposit, then you can't obtain any clay in that zone either. Awesome. Clay is the basis for a completely new building material. Don't forget that the clay pit benefits from a connection to a road. Now the newly obtained clay has to be fired into bricks. The brickworks does this. It's best if you place it near the clay pit.
going. I'm at the wheel. On my way. New instructions? Got it? These factory grounds are less damaged than the rest of the wastelands. Let's see what we can find here.
I'll do it.
Looks interesting. I'm in. Let's go. New instructions?
These factory grounds are less damaged than the rest of the wastelands. Let's see what we can find here. Let's go. I'll do it. I'm in. Let's go. I'm in. Let's go. On the road. On the road. On the road. On the road.
I'm at the wheel. On my way.
As you see, the brickworks begins to work right away when coal and clay are made available to it.
I'm at the wheel. I'm at the wheel.
The manufacturing of bricks needs a lot of manpower. But before you build new houses, bear in mind that, in addition to more water and food,
new instructions?
There's a converted buggy standing in this garage. We ought to take a closer look at it. The best would be if we try to lower the car lift somehow. I'll do it. The mattress hasn't been used for a while, but whoever fixed up their cars here lived here for a spell too. The mattress hasn't been used for a while, but whoever fixed up their cars here lived here for a spell, too. Sure is lonesome out here. On the road.
Engine running.
You're doing just fine. If I'm too fast for you or something goes wrong, then let me wait and take care of the survival of our settlement. Build, when necessary, new jetties, wells, fish. Besides radiation, the health of a settlement can become a problem too. The more settlers, the faster a settlement's state of health. Thank you.
Engine running. Got it. On my way.
If a settlement's state of health declines, then the risk of sicknesses increases. But we're not able to use the herbs raw. First, they have to be processed into medicine. That's done by the pharmacist, who requires plastic and herbs to do it. We'll be right back.
I'm at the wheel. Let's go.
The medicine is ready and waiting, but now we still have to hand it out to the settlers. This doesn't happen automatically. Handing out medicine takes place via the pharmacy. It supplies all the dwellings in its surroundings.
I'm at the wheel. Got it? Engine running.
We have found a new zone. Take a look at it when you get a chance. It might be worth it to build a new settlement on it.
Engine running! All clear. On my way. Let's go.
Thank you.
When enough settlers have access to medical care, a zone's state of health will stabilize itself. Although this doesn't rule out the outbreak of sicknesses, it does make sure that our settlement can overcome the sickness much better. Besides radiation and health, you ought to pay attention to our settlers' confidence as well. If the mood is not good, this leads to problems. Settlers can sweeten up their lives with a bit of luxury at a marketplace. Like the pharmacy, the market supplies all dwellings in its surrounding area. The market uses up a lot of food. When food starts to run out, you can give the market a pause to conserve. Besides radiation, the environment can punish us with long dry spells too. We have to prepare ourselves well for a drought like that and make sure to stockpile sufficient water and food.
Weather seems to be changing. We ought to prepare ourselves for a draft. We're better off stockpiling sufficient water and food so that we are well equipped.
Thank you.
Engine running!
There's a converted buggy standing in this garage. We ought to take a closer look at it. The best would be if we tried to lower the car lift somehow. Jerry cans with gasoline in them are lying here. Can we use them? I'll pack that. Generators running and supplying electricity. That worked. That's a really unusual construction design. The vehicle's not fit to... The mattress hasn't been used for a while. But whoever fixed up their cars here lived here for a spell too. Sure is lonesome out here. I'll pack that.
New instructions? All clear. New instructions? All clear. Instructions.
There's lots of scrap lying around here. We're sure to find things that are still useful here. We'll pack it. On the road. On the road. This delivery van is locked. With the right tools, we're sure to get it open. Will do! I can't do it! We can't do it like this. Let's go! On the road! Let's go! On the road! Take this with me. On the road. Let's go. It worked. I can't do it. delivery van is locked. With the right tools, we're sure to get it open. This old safe can't be cracked without substantial effort. A truly lucky find. This species of plant seeds is unknown to us. We'll take them with us. I'll take a look. This delivery van is locked. With the right tools, we're sure to get it open.
I'm at the wheel. On my way. Engine running. Where are we going? Let's go. Thank you. Got it? Got it? Got it? Got it?
Jetties and fisheries are not able to produce during a drought, and nothing will grow on our plantations anymore either. You can reallocate the settlers normally active there to other kinds of production. When water or food gets scarce, you have to react quickly. Give the market and weaving mill a pause to conserve food and water. Another well is equally helpful. Sometimes every drop counts.
A draft has come. Hopefully our supplies will be enough to last.
New instructions? New instructions? On my way. Let's go. Got it?
This country house is still in good shape. We ought to take a look around and see if we find any...
New instructions? On my way.